The answer is D.
Acetaminophen is a pain medication that is widely prescribed and you do not need a prescription to get hold of it. It is not an opioid. In contrast, opioid drugs require a prescription, and they do require a prescription because they are rewarding and can produce addiction. And also opioids, when ingested at higher doses or combined with alcohol or other drugs, carry with them a risk of overdose deaths from respiratory depression.
The answer is A.
Very few kids ages 12 to 17, about 1 out of 10, in fact, drank alcohol in the past month. So most, about 9 out of 10 kids, did not.
The answer is B.
Once the pill is swallowed, it takes about 15 minutes for it to reach the brain. That's where it has its effects, by increasing the activity of neurotransmitters or chemical messengers like serotonin, dopamine, and norepinephrine.
The answer is A.
Year after year, alcohol and marijuana are the most commonly used substances by high school seniors. After those two drugs, it's the nicotine found in non-cigarette tobacco products that are most common. This includes small cigars, hookah, and also e-cigarettes.
The answer is A, B, and D.
When cough and cold medicines are taken as directed, they can help you fight the symptoms of cold and flu. However, when they're taken in higher doses, or when cold or flu symptoms aren't present, they can affect your brain in ways similar to illegal drugs. They can actually also make your heart beat dangerously faster.
The answer is D.
Kids are attracted to alcohol for a number of reasons. As kids mature, it is natural for them to assert independence, seek new challenges, and take risks on the way to becoming adults. Drinking may be one of those risks.
The answer is B and D.
It turns out that we know very little about the impact of e-cigarettes. We do know that nicotine is not safe. Nicotine is addictive, habit-forming, and may impact brain development, particularly for teenagers that use these e-cigarette products.
You should have checked all.
That's right, all of those are ways people have died using inhalants. Each year, there are many deaths when people try to use inhalants to try to get high. For more information, check out the Nitotine website.
The answer is E.
This was a little tricky question that we put for you to see if you were paying attention. What we know so far from scientific studies is that marijuana has very bad side effects, and yet there's very little benefit or no benefit so far. There are pills that are approved that contain THC, which is part of what is in marijuana, that can benefit the treatment of people who have nausea due to chemotherapy or treatment of cancer, or who have low appetite due to AIDS.
The answer is B.
Drinking alcohol can cause kids to have accidents and get hurt. In 2010 alone, 189,000 people under the age of 21 visited an emergency room for alcohol-related injuries.
The answer is A.
That's right, they're the brain's chemical messengers. So there are these compounds that go from one cell to another cell in our brains, and it's how our brain communicates with one another. And you should know there are different flavors of neurotransmitters. There's dopamine, there's glutamate, there's serotonin, there's endorphins, and these are just different compounds that act on the brain that give you different types of feelings. And dopamine is probably the one that we study the most in drug abuse research because it's really important in how we feel pleasure and joy. And it turns out that when drugs of abuse are on board, they overwhelm the system with this neurotransmitter called dopamine, and we're actually not able to feel joy and pleasure like we should feel when drugs of abuse are on board.
The answer is C.
The brainstem is a very important part of the brain. It controls basic functions like heartbeat, respiration, and sleeping, for example. Brainstem also connects the brain with the rest of the body, where it controls things like movement. But it also brings back to the brain signals from the external world, and this is what we perceive.